was unknown to most of popular music, but that was about to change. Selena was to become the industry's next crossover artist, standing on the threshold of mainstream stardom.
She's crying. She's
definitely crying.
Oh, she's no. She's doing something. Oh, moving up. They're out of the way.
All of those dreams and promises snuffed out with a single gunshot wound to the upper body Friday. Police say this woman is the gunman, Yolanda Saldivar, the founder of Selena's first fan club in 1991.
In Corpus Christi, Texas, thousands of mourners paid their respects today to Selena, the Tejano music star murdered on Friday.
The story is heard around the world.
But as Scott Pelley reports, the young woman was about to be.
To millions, she was a diva. And today, the fans of Selena Quintanilla Perez came to see their rising star for the last time.
There's a hole in our hearts that is missing because of Tejano music. I think Tejano music is going down without Selena.
Almost unknown in mainstream music, Texas-born artist Selena was a star of Tejano, an accordion-based mix of rock, ranchera, polka, and reggae.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Dave Johnson, reporting tonight from San Antonio, Texas. The death of Selena Quintanilla last Friday shocked the entire state of Texas, shocked many in the nation. But the real problems behind the shooting began 160 miles to the north, here in San Antonio, at Selena's boutique on Broadway Street. It was this boutique which opened back in October, and a boutique that Yolanda Saldivar began operating.
Saldivar had proven herself so helpful in running Selena's fan club, she was hired to manage Selena's store in Corpus Christi and in San Antonio. Published reports say she had a key to the home Selena shared with her husband, Chris, control over Selena's business checking accounts, and increasingly, hostility over anyone who tried to question her authority.
There are 5,000 tulips being flown in from Holland. Here is just another massive display of flowers just in the San Antonio area. And we're not even talking about any of the other cities in or around this area. Authorities say Yolanda Saldivar was one of Selena's closest friends. But unfortunately, according to the authorities, she had a fondness for money. It was a money problem that apparently led to their breakup. Published reports say she had a fondness for rental cars and cellular phones. She also reportedly spent a whole lot of money on buying new clothes just before a trip to Mexico.
Saldivar quit her job as a registered nurse to become Selena's road mom. But money would apparently ruin the relationship between the pair. On Wednesday, Selena was forced to fire Yolanda Saldivar over financial discrepancies. The next day, Saldivar reportedly phoned Selena and arranged for a meeting at the Days Inn on Navigation and Interstate 37. Jimmy Gonzalez, who was with Selena's production studio in Corpus Christi, says there was no fight when Saldivar was fired. She just said, okay. Selena then reportedly proceeded to the motel, went to room 158, and was shot once in the shoulder. Selena died shortly afterwards. Saldivar barricaded herself inside of a red pickup truck for a 9.5-hour standoff before giving up. She's under a suicide watch at the Nueces County Jail. In San Antonio, hundreds of fans are paying their last respects, from kids to adults. Most of them stand in stunned silence.
We don't have words enough to say our deepest sentiments for her and her family. We live kind of far away from here, but we came just to pay our tributes to her.
Where did you come from?
We live by Westlake. Mm-hmm. And as soon as we heard it, we've been listening to the radio and to the TV stations. It's very sad. It's a very sad. I don't know what this woman was thinking when she killed her. I don't know, that's maybe the devil, was in her mind or something, because
there are signs for people to write on. Some of the messages are hauntingly simple and right to the point. 5-year-old Jonathan Pena holds a Polaroid, showing him with an autographed Selena picture. He too has a message.
Selena, I'm sorry you died. I hope I will pray for you. I hope you feel better. I'm sorry, but you are with Jesus, so I will remember you. Love, Jonathan. Look on the site.
You know, for such a young man, you probably said something that a lot of adults don't know what to say right now.
Well.
Priscilla and Laura Jean Ramirez have come to pay homage to a woman they considered a role model.
I think that we all love her and that she knows she'll always be in our hearts. She'll always live through her music and everything.
Does it make it easier for you to come here and pay your respects?
Yes, because she's been an idol for both of us, and it's like a sad moment. We're still in shock to hear that she passed away like that. And it's just unbelievable, but we know that she'll keep on living through us, through her music, and she's the role model to all the Tejanos and everything. So.
And in her hometown of Corpus Christi, Selena fans are out in droves. Many in stunned silence. Many needing an outlet to release their grief.
We were surprised to see she was there. It's just unbelievable she's gone.
I don't feel like she's here. I feel like they have her at the funeral home.
He wanted to dispel the rumors that she wasn't here, and he did that by opening the casket. And he's so sad, and he wants to make somebody happy, so he decided to show the public once again that this was a real thing.
She broke my heart when she died when they killed her with a gun.
In the months before her death, the girl with the booming soprano voice was making her way straight to the top. This is the Hard Rock Cafe in downtown San Antonio, a restaurant famous for its musical memorabilia. The restaurant opened its doors here on Crockett Street in January. Only a big-time group opens up a Hard Rock Cafe, and guess who opened up this one? That's right, Selena Quintanilla. Here's a portion of that performance. On this afternoon, a packed house would give Selena a standing ovation and pay respect to her memory.
Her beauty and talent will remain part of the Hard Rock family forever. She'll be a part of the Hard Rock family, so we'd like to picture you, Selena. Thank you.
They're remembering Selena Quintanilla at the Hard Rock Cafe by her video. And indeed, the dress she wore at the Grammys, the one she won the Grammy in, soon one day hang on these walls alongside Roy Orbison, the Beatles, Ringo Starr, and a multitude of other artists who have made it big in popular music. More on Selena Quintanilla, her life and times, after this. The Tejano Music Awards have become the Selena Show in recent years. She had dominated the top honors. Song of the Year, Album of the Year, Female Vocalist of the Year.
I would like to thank every one of you for making this possible. I'd like to thank my band, Selena Los Zinos, who are right now in Florida, waiting for me to go back over there tomorrow. I also like to thank the Selena Los Zinos fan club, my sponsors Coca-Cola Classic, Agree Shampoo. Did I leave somebody out? My banker, is he? Thanks to all of you. Thank you, San Antonio. Muchas gracias por todo.
The moment you've been waiting for, the nominees for the 15th annual Tejano Music Awards Record of the Year are
Amor Prohibido, Selena y los Dinos.
Amor prohibido, murmuran por las calles, porque somos en distintas sociedades. Amor prohibido.
And the winner is...
One, two, three.
Selena.
A thank you to the West Texas area, Odessa, Midland. Also to Dallas, Austin, Corpus Christi, Robestown. Todos en México, bienvenidos una vez más. A todos ustedes de Dallas, Texas. Thank you once again. Y'all take care and we hope to see y'all real soon. Gracias a todos ustedes. Thank you.
By the time I was attending college in 1987, young Selena was beginning to blossom as a young lady and as an entertainer. She was rapidly gaining popularity, and anyone who heard her or saw her perform realized that she was destined for greatness. She was an exciting entertainer, but also an honest role model. She was representing us well. We were very proud of her.
Two, Selena would play her hometown Memorial Coliseum for an album called Selena Live. It would earn her her first Grammy. Selena was barely out of her teens when I first interviewed her, but showed a maturity beyond her years. What most impressed me was her sincerity and her glowing smile.
How's it feel to be back here in Corpus?
It feels good. It's good to be back here and have our family and friends supporting us here in our hometown.
Well, it seems like everything you touch seems to turn to gold. All your records are so hot, they keep going up.
I think that's part of the up to the fans. You know, we just dish out the music, and they're the ones who buy it. So,
how'd you get started on this? Who were some of your influences when you were growing up?
My influences were, I would say, with my father. My father used to have a band way back when, and I guess it's where we got the musical talent from. And as far as other groups, I used to listen to Taste of Honey, a little bit of rock, AC/DC, just different music. I listen to everything.
I don't see the AC/DC reflection
in what
you do now.
But I mean, every singer has their interests when they're growing up and the things they listen to, and little things that a singer might do or that a musician might play in a song will be later on, come out later on. That's how everybody gets their own sound, because you take little bits and you make your own sound.
Did you ever think a couple of years ago you'd be in this situation?
No.
That you are?
Never.
What's it like?
Well, it's like a dream come true. I mean, there's been a lot of hard work that we put into it, but you know what? When you get hard work, you get success, and we've put a lot of years into it, 12 years now, and we're really happy. Never thought we'd get this far, but we're here, so.
You're probably one of the biggest names that come out of here since, I guess, Freddie Fender,
Farrah Fawcett.
You're it's a pretty slick company.
Well, I'm very honored, flattered too.
Why did you pick the Coliseum? I guess for obvious reasons.
We wanted the Coliseum because we felt like, you know, Coliseum has been here for years, and everybody can associate bands and concerts with the Coliseum, and it's great to be here.
What would you want to tell the people of Corpus?
Well, I'd like to tell them thanks for all the support they've given us, and I know at the beginning it was kind of hard for us here in Corpus. It was, well, for a lot of groups, it's hard for the hometown to back up their hometown groups, but there was a lot of people that stuck by our side here in Corpus, and we give you all a whole bunch of thanks from the bottom of our hearts. We appreciate you made us what we are today, so thanks.
Thanks.
Between 1989 and 92, Selena was on the verge of stardom. She was performing in Mexico, South and Central America, and preparing to sing with Julio Iglesias. All of us who were her fans could see how great she was as a singer and a performer, and also how wonderful she was as a person. She was honest, she was moral, and she was humble. She never forgot her roots. From all of us, Selena, we love you.
Selena would play the Coliseum again, just months before her death. The hometown magic doing wonders for the crowd and Selena herself.
We usually don't play here often, so every time we come here, it's great because we get to see a bunch of our friends and family, and they come and hang out with us.
Yeah.
lot of music. They're proud of their culture, where they come from. It's cool to talk Spanish now, as before a lot of young kids thought it was uncool. And it's really great to see that the younger generation's taking a look at their culture and really appreciating it. And I think that's one of the reasons it's growth. I'm coming out next year in February. Producer Keith Thomas, which is a producer for Vanessa Williams and Amy Grant, will be producing half of the album. And also there'll be a well-known producer that'll be finishing out the rest of it. So we're really excited about it. It's gonna be great.
Selena had gone from playing clubs as a teenager to stadiums. Music was her life, but not all of it. She felt a strong obligation to her roots, to the children who idolized her. And so earlier this year, Selena cut a video, a combination music and instruction video, combining the history of Tejano music with a stay-in-school message.
I've gotten so many letters from fans inviting me to their schools, so I'd like to invite you to mine. In fact, I'm going to play teacher today. Y'all play the students, okay? Check out my visual aids, video chalkboard, a great sound system, and a dance floor. Today I'm going to share with you some of what I know about music in Spanish that many Mexican-American teenagers all over the United States enjoy today. I'm going to concentrate on Texas and California, where most Mexican-American music is created. As I give you a short history of Mexicans in Texas, I want you to think about how the following political and economic events could have had an effect on music. There were Spanish settlements in the area of New Spain that would become Texas beginning in 1690. The region was already populated by a number of American Indian tribes, and Catholic missions were set up to convert the Indians. Tejano, or Texas Mexican culture, was very much tied to the commercial and cultural center of Monterrey and the Mexican state of Nuevo León. In the 1850s, Germans emigrated to Mexico and to Monterrey, as well as to the United States. Before, after, and during the years of 1910 to 1917, thousands of Mexicans immigrated into Texas, California, and the Southwest. These families were fleeing from the violence of the Mexican Revolution and economic disaster. Many were highly educated professionals. Any ideas about how all this affected music? How about you? Or maybe you? Bueno, Monterrey supplied many music teachers and musicians to South Texas. The German immigrants to Monterrey brought the accordion, polka, waltz, and other European dance styles, which became popular throughout Mexico and South Texas. The bottom line is that the Tejanos were able to develop a very distinctive musical style because of their isolation. We'll talk about that best-known style now. Tejano music is known for its use of el acordeón, the accordion, and for the polka ranchera, waltz, and other rhythms of German origin. Tejano music is performed by conjuntos, orquestas, or grupos. Conjuntos have from 2 to 4 members, with 2 members singing in harmony. The principal instrument is the acordeón, accompanied by a bajo sexto, bass, and drums. The guitar-related instruments trace their heritage to Spain. Orquestas are much larger and include brass instruments such as trumpets, wind instruments such as saxophones and clarinets, and violins. The acordeón may be included. Grupos are smaller and often use synthesizers to create a brass, string, and even acordeón sounds. And now, I will show you how to dance a polka. Waltzes are not quite as common, but are danced especially at weddings and quinceañeras, debutante parties. Another rhythm that is very popular is the cumbia. It's a kind of música tropical, or tropical music, because it comes from Colombia and has Afro-Colombian roots. We don't play it in the same way as Colombians do. Cumbia came a long way up through Mexico, and we adapted it in Texas. When we dance cumbia, we can dance side by side, or even together. Let's move on to California. Just joking. Anyway, the history of Mexican Americans in Southern California is similar, but different enough to have an effect on the music that is popular there. The first Spanish mission in what is now California was founded in San Diego in 1769. The Pueblo of Los Angeles was founded near the mission of San Gabriel in the year 1781. The Mexicans who moved into the area were often from the state of Sonora. The heavy immigration from Mexico from the late 1800s to the 1930s helped to strengthen Mexican culture in Southern California. The ranchera music of Jalisco has always been especially popular in Southern California. Norteño music is also very popular there. Banda, which means band, is also the name of a style of dance music from Zacatecas and Sinaloa, Mexico. It is extremely popular in California right now. Rap and hip-hop are very popular among teenagers, and you might know that already. There are Mexican-American rap groups out of East Los Angeles. Their rap pulls together African-American rap styles, Spanish language, and some Mexican-American topics. So, mis amigos, we've learned a little about the history of Texas and California and how history can affect music. We've heard examples of musical styles in Spanish that are popular with Mexican-American teenagers, like Tejano and Norteña Polka, Waltz and Cumbia, Rap and Banda. And you remember that all Mexican-Americans have different tastes, depending on our family, our history, and our environment. Hey, and one more thing I especially want you to know, and the main reason I've come to see you, your high school diploma, is one of the most important things you'll ever achieve in your life. So use your head, my friends. Stay in school. See ya.
How Do I Love Thee by Elizabeth Barrett Browning. How do I love thee? Let me count the ways. I love thee to the depth and breadth and height my soul can reach when feeling out of sight for the ends of being and ideal grace. I love thee to the level of everyday's most quiet need by sun and candlelight. I love thee freely as men strive for right. I love thee purely as they turn from praise. I love thee with a passion put to use in my old griefs and with my childhood's faith. I love thee with a love I seem to lose with my lost saints. I love with the breath, smiles, tears of all my life. And if God choose, Selena, I shall but love thee better after death.
As a little girl, she would sing with her father's bands in various tiny clubs. As a young woman, she would eventually pack the Astrodome. I have lost a personal friend. This world has lost much more than that. I'm Dave Johnson, and that's our tribute to Selena.
Thank you, buenas noches. Woo! Yeah!
¿Dónde queda Coca-Cola, Texas?
No me queda más que perderme en un abismo de tristeza y lágrimas. No me queda más si tu regreso y sería una imposibilidad.
It is a tragedy. It'll be felt by the many people that loved her. Selena has accomplished so much, broken so many records, broken so many barriers for Tejano artists and Latin artists alike, and just simply any recording artist. Awesome. That's the only word you can describe Selena.